In the fourth part of the tutorial, we'll be covering jump linking, exporting our verticals, and using the MagPlus production tool. Jump linking can be used to jump the user to a specific point in the vertical or in the iPad app. Let's look at an example. Say we are designing a feature on Columbia's 30 Under 30. We have our intro page displaying all 30 people. If the user scrolls, they'll see that we have blurbs and a larger photo of each individual. But if our user wanted to go to a specific person, we wouldn't want them to have to scroll all the way to the bottom. This is when jump links come in handy. With our object selected, we'll add a link, resize our clickable area to the dimensions we need, and change the hotspot type to jump link. Now we need to tell our jump link where to take us. Since we're jump linking to the same vertical, in the URL field we'll type ../, and then an object ID. We'll name this one person1. Now we'll go to our object and name it person1. Remember, linking should always be the final step because grouping and ungrouping objects will break the link. We'll also want to add a back to top link. To do this, we'll click the selected object, add a link, change the hotspot type to jump link, and type a / in the URL field. Let's fast review our design. When we click our clickable area, it takes us to our object ID that we assigned it to. And when we click go to top, it takes us back to the top of the vertical. To add additional jump links to the same layer, we'll copy and paste our clickable area or Option Command Drag, place it where we want it to be, and give it a new object ID name in the URL. So person 2 and the firefighter person 3. Then we'll add the object ID name to the corresponding object on the page we want it to jump to. So person 2 and person 3. Let's fast review our design. We can see that when we click the firefighter, it takes us to the corresponding object. Same for this guy. We can also jump link to different verticals and even to different issues. But first, let's export this vertical to the MagPlus production app. If we look at our MagPlus vertical palette, we'll see a few different options for exporting. Remember, always stick with the same template version throughout your build. Do not switch between the templates. We've been working with the iPad 2 version template, but we want to create a version for the iPad Retina as well. Thankfully, all we have to do is click Additional Devices. Here we can see that the iPad is grayed out since it's our current device. We will still need to check V for vertical next to it though. We'll check the box next to Retina and click Vertical as well. And we'll unselect any devices that we do not need. We'll save our vertical and export to additional devices. After exporting, we should see a dialog box telling us the status of our export and whether or not it succeeded. Now we can open the MagPlus Production Tool application. To expedite this demo, I've already exported our other verticals. The first thing we'll do in the production tool is direct it to our issue folder. We'll need to set up a new brand settings. We can do this by going to File, open Brand Settings Editor, click New, insert a brand ID name, brand description, and set our default MIB version. Remember, everyone should be working with the same MIB version. And we'll save it. We'll make sure that our brand that we just created is selected, and we'll give it an issue ID name. And save. We can see that it automatically populated the verticals that we've exported. And we're viewing the iPad 2 issue folder. To view the Retina, we'll just redirect it. So we'll need to make sure that we order both the Retina version and the iPad 2 version. But for now, let's just focus on the iPad 2 version. We'll drag and drop our verticals in the order we want them to appear in the app. Since we named our InDesign file names with the number they appear with and at the beginning, it's really easy to reorder them in the production tool. This also ensures that everyone involved with producing the app is aware of page order. To review our issue, we'll go to Preferences, make sure our push address is correct, make sure push is selected, and we can click Review All. Everything appears to be working how we'd like it to, but we still need to add a jump link on the cover. We'll go back to our InDesign file for the cover, which we can access by double-clicking the preview in our Mag Plus Production app. Let's hide our Media and Clickable Areas layers temporarily. We'll add a jump link like before, selecting our object, clicking Add Link, and changing the hotspot type to jump link. Except this time, we're going to select a vertical from the drop-down list. We can even select a certain point in the vertical, as long as that point has an object ID. Let's select person 1. We'll turn back on our clickable and media area layers. And since this clickable area is on top, it gets priority over the clickable area that pauses the video. Making sure that no A layer is selected, we're now ready to export to additional devices. Now we'll go back to the Mag Plus Production tool, hit refresh, and review it in the iOS simulator. So we can see that our cover cell line went exactly to the point that we set our jump link to. And we can also see that we're able to pause and start the video. Okay, our build is ready to go and we can now create our MIB. Remember, we'll need to create a MIB for both our Retina and our iPad 2 version. If we look in our issue folder, we'll see our MIB. We'll want to review this on an actual device, so we'll put the MIB file in a public folder in Dropbox. Next, we'll copy the public URL and we can send it via email. If we go into the Mag Plus Reviewer app, we can paste that URL in the Remote Review field and then download it. This is an amazing feature for when we're collaborating with team members and someone needs to view something and they're not physically there. As long as we put it on a public server space and send the URL, they'll be able to review it either on their device or the simulator. And it's as close to the published product as we can get.